On the count of three, give a big happy birthiversary shout out to everybody here, the staff that's been putting on the convention for all these years, the leadership, and all of you attendees who've been coming. So how about we do a 3, 2, 1 happy birthiversary? Sound good?
Yes. Yeah.
3, 2, 1.
Happy birthday!
Interviewing a lot of you about your favorite convention memories, and I'm so excited to get to meet new friends and catch up with old friends. Today I have my foals with me. As you know, I'm front page, and we have
Novella.
Now if they get in trouble, don't forget I am their mom, so just come and let me know and I'll be sure to get them in good order. No worries. And we have two of my best friends in the whole pony world here.
Hi, I'm Marina.
Happy Hungry Creature.
And if I didn't have my morning mocha latte, I don't know what I would do without this, darling.
You're welcome.
Keep talking, because that's what journalists do. We like to talk and talk and talk and not really bring you any news at all. I think we do have a few things, though, that we can talk about.
We do. We actually have to introduce our lovely con chairs.
Oh, that's so exciting. So, we are going to introduce our con chairs, and we're going to go backstage and get prepared to be even more exciting and more hypey, because that's what we're here for. We're to hype you up. Woo! Is not to tell people what your secret mission is, so I just broke the fourth wall for you. All right, everybody, let's bring on those fabulous con chairs.
So give it a hand for our lovely con chairs, Buttons and Sybil.
All right, good morning, Everfree Northwest 2022. Woo! Wonderful to see everyone here. My name is Simmel. I am the chair for Everfree Northwest 2022. Joined here by?
I'm Button. I'm the vice chair for Everfree Northwest. I'm so happy to see you guys all here.
It is so great to see you. We've got a wonderful weekend planned for everybody here. As you know, this year marks our 10th birth anniversary, believe it or not. Woo! 10 years of Everfree Northwest that we have been coming and spending time together for that long. It's crazy to imagine. We've got a lot of fun things this weekend planned. We're gonna give you some useful information here as we get started. We're gonna meet some of our VIPs a little bit later. But I think to get started, we've got a nice little presentation. If people at front of house wanna throw that up, we've got something fun one of our staff put together to enjoy. So please enjoy.
Ladies and gentlemen,
we're about to kick off our front of house.
Everfree 2012, we went upstairs to go in the room and see Thursday.
Well, my favorite part about that was you had to take an elevator to get to the concert.
So there was the entire convention. Every main panel was in that room. So, like,
everyone actually showed up.
Say, everyone, you want to know something weird? Back in 2012, I walked into this convention and met you for the very first time.
But he's going the wrong way, Andrew. The hotel's that way.
That's
the one. That's, oh, you're right. It's actually over here, up this hill.
Oh, no, it's that one.
Right. As we referenced in past convention vlogs, what used to be a Holiday Inn, up there, the first pony stalk was taking place. In the windows, we looked out upon the land and said, what would be the future for pony conventions?
Radio.
welcome everybody to the first annual Everfree Northwest.
Instead of searching for the light yourself, reflecting on the moments you lost, the moments you thought would finally be the end.
Searching for the light in the dead of the night, when I could light the way for someone else. Forgetting all the moments I lost, the more that I thought I'd never see me.
Sitting there at the front of house. Everyone say, hi, Morgan.
Hi!
All right, well, 10 years, so much can change. One of the things that doesn't change is that it takes a lot of work to put a convention like this together. So one of the first things we want to do is recognize some of our staff. So any directors that are able to come on up here and be recognized, come on up. Woo! So many of them. So These are a few members of our executive team who are in charge of the various departments here at the convention and make sure everything runs smoothly. You can see they're all wearing this wonderful green staff shirt. This is how you'll be able to find us in case you have any questions that you need to address. Green shirts are your friends here. So we have B-Ben, who is in charge of productions. We have Tycho in charge of IT. Yeah, let's keep it rolling. Bravery for PR. Joey for horse resources. Ruth Dallas is our director of operations. Tiggs is our director of guest relations, standing with the IT. Spiral Kips is our new events director. We have Curtis, a member of our board, and also helping out with our charity this year. That's Button. That's Button right there. And then this, at the end, is some guy who sings. That's Thorn, a member of our board. Opening act. So, folks you'll see around the event this weekend wearing this green shirt are there to help you out. If you have any trouble at all, any questions, concerns, you can feel free to not hesitate to reach out. All right, so if you see staff running around, we've all got lots of different tasks to complete this weekend. We'll all be taking care of you, doing lots of different things. If you ever have a free moment, make sure to just give a quick thank you, because it's a lot of work to put these together. So round of applause for our directors and for all of our volunteers. Okay, so we're going to go over just a few of our convention policies real quick. Okay. The first of which has to do with the elephant in the room, COVID, right? Mm-hmm. So this is now our second year where we have had policies in place to try and reduce the impact of COVID on our event. We want our event to be safe. We want all of you to be safe and healthy and happy. And I'm really happy to see how many people out here we have wearing their masks. Masks are going to be required in all of the convention-controlled spaces, with very few exceptions. If you need to sit down, take a drink, eat food, we don't expect you to try and do that through your mask. You may, in fact, take that off.
Please do not walk through the vendor hall with, like, a hot dog and no mask in sight. Yeah. Eating while walking, you know. Just respect the people around you.
There's a lot of seating in this hotel, if you haven't noticed. So you will find places to sit down and eat. Lots of food options, too, by the way. We're attached to a mall, in fact. You can also, if you're participating on stage in a panel event, you may remove your mask for that occasion. And if you're snapping, like, a quick photo or something, want to get your face in there, that's fine, too. Just be sure to replace your mask promptly. It's got to snugly cover the nose and the mouth, and face shields on their own are not going to satisfy that requirement, just so everybody knows. I think our screen here has some rather humorous demonstrations of what not to do.
If your mask breaks, or if you lose it, we have disposable masks available at registration, so please get one if you need one.
That's right. We'll all stay safe and healthy. A few other things to be aware of. Our convention policies, if you have a con book, you will find near the front of that book is a list of all of our policies, our code of conduct that we expect everyone here to adhere to. And you can find those policies, of course, on our website as well. You can visit the link everfreenw.com/about/policy. One specific policy we really want to bring your attention to is our anti-harassment policy. We have zero tolerance for harassment. So that means behavior that intends to threaten, intimidate, scare, be nice to each other, right? And if you should encounter an issue at the convention, we have a set protocol within our staff for dealing with these issues, but it only works if we're told about the problem and we're told about it promptly. So for your convenience, our Royal Guard staff, those are the people in charge of attendee safety, they'll be wearing blue shirts. We may have some in the room. If there's any, maybe they might be out in the halls. They look exactly like these.
Elsewhere.
They look exactly like these shirts, same pattern, but they're blue and they say Royal Guard on the back. Those are going to be the people best suited to deal with any issues you may encounter while at the convention. But we want to be happy and we want to respect each other, yeah?
Yeah.
I know we can trust you guys. All right. Cool. Well, Feel free to review those policies at any time. I think for now we're going to go ahead and invite Curtis back up on stage to talk a little bit about our charity for this year. Say what for Curtis.
Hello. So yeah, this year, last couple of years, we're partnering with Washington Autism Alliance for the prime beneficiary of our charity auction. The charity auction, as it says on screen right now, is Sunday. If you have donations today, you can bring them to the info desk. And all these hours are listed on the website under like department hours. However, there is a mistake. It indicates on the website that you should bring them to registration. Bring them to the info desk, which is across from registration. They can take your donations today. Tomorrow, you can go to Balsam, the Balsam Room, which will be the charity showcase. And we are continuing from last year. We are not doing a silent auction. Instead, we're just doing a flat price auction. So if you see something on Saturday that's in the flat price auction area, which is something you don't plan to bring to the live auction, you want it, you can just buy it right there. You can also, at that point, view the stuff that will be available during the live auction on Sunday, and Sunday is the live auction. So, hope to see you there. It's charity for this year.
I said it last year, I'll say it again this year. I heard you guys like merch. We have some really cool new designs. Our 10-year t-shirt is available at the con store. Our Everfree Northwest hat with embroidery on the front and back is available at the con store. We have the fanny packs from last year featuring two packets where I have our Marina pin or a Marina coin from last year designed by Choco Pony. And we have a new mascot. Do you see it on the screen? Who is it?
Front Page!
Front Page! TBD, who's next year? You guys gotta keep coming and keep getting them from the con store. We have a new tote bag, which is really something sweet. It's got the birthiversary art on it. I have two ponies still for sale at the con store. We have, you guys say her name, come on. And we have
Fun Page.
Wow, you guys are good at this. We also have a new poster for the birthiversary. This one is super cool. It's got art of all of our special guests, so you can get that at the con store and go get some autographs. What else we got? I need lots of hands for this one. These are in very limited supply and they are at the con store while they last. We only have a few left, so please go get one if you want one. It's huge, it's fluffy, it's Marina! Also got some tote bags available with a purchase from the con store to carry your stuff in. These are our tote bags from last year. They're pretty cool. And the last thing that I want to highlight is that if you have a foal with you, if you have a kiddo, we have a box of vintage Everfree merch that kids can dig through and take something for free. Free merch for the kiddos, all right? So stop by the con store, all right? That's all I got for you.
Hello, everyone. Stuff. So first and foremost, for those of you, if this is like your first Everfree, your first con, or maybe you just want to make some new friends, don't forget after the convention, or after the opening, after the convention is closed. Yeah, after opening ceremony is here at 11:15 over in Cadence, right over there. We're going to have Making Friends is Magic, and we're going to have this panel both today and tomorrow at 9:45 a.m. So for those of you who like to wake up in the morning and If not, just kind of sorry about that. Not much I can do. And for the mobile schedule, you can always go to everfreenw.com/events. And we have all the schedule on there. It's divided by 3 tabs. If you don't see what you're looking for, make sure you change the proper tab. It's Friday, Saturday, Sunday. And there's also a fantastic little feature to it called the My Schedule, where if you click on any of the events you're actually interested in, you can then add it to your schedule, and when you scroll down, you'll be able to see everything you want to go to and nothing else. And on top of that, there's even a little option to download as a PDF, so you can have it there and easily accessible. And the site's always up to date. Then not only do we have the schedule on there, we also have the con book, the con map, and an area map. So if you're ever feeling lost in any way, then you can just go onto the site and then you can find all those resources to figure out where you are and maybe find some food. Then another thing, every year we always have some things that need to get changed. So there are a couple errors in the con book that have been changed. So for the character creation panel in the writing room on Sunday, that is now going to be writing for role-playing at 1 p.m. And then also the attendee feedback panel is at 6:15 p.m., not 6 p.m. Additionally, we unfortunately had some things come up, so some changes for musicians. So instead of Mathematic Pony, we're going to have Luck Rock replacing. Ooh. And then Protoshades was unable to make it, so we have Faulty.
Ooh, so,
speaking about that, don't forget to come tonight for Ponystock Live, where we have like live performances of like bands, and then afterwards we'll have Ponystock Dance, where it's DJs. And similarly, tomorrow we'll have the gala where you can come in semi-formal wear and just have a good time, and then they'll have a little bit of an after party, some harder music and some electronic stuff going on. So, hope to see you there.
Wow, that was a lot of news. I was trying to keep track back there. Hopefully I got everything recorded properly for the Everfree Press. I think that we have some other news that's very important to everybody that's here today. How about we learn who our VIP guests of honor are? We love each and every one of these ponies that are here today, so in no particular order of importance, we are going to bring on our first VIP guest. And first up, we have the voice of Pinkie Pie, Alan Fluttershy, Andrea Levin.
Hi, everybody.
Hi, Andrea.
Are you ready to have fun?
Too much fun, that's for sure. Thank you. And next up, we have our voice of Izzy. Everybody, welcome Anna Sani. Fabulous fashion on the back of your jacket. It says "My Friends."
Made by Tails.
Wow.
Next up, we have the pony you know and love as Big Mac. And
you're gonna have a good time?
Yeah!
Yup! Come on!
And mimicking Pinky, I think we should do a yup. Ready? Go!
Yup!
we have our voice of Gilda and Sonata Dusk, Marika Hendricks.
Hello, I guess.
Hi, Dean.
I am certain I'm going to get some enthusiastic interviews out of her today.
That was Gilda, in case anyone was confused.
Yep.
And next up, we have the fabulous artist, Justa Suda. Woo! Some art for the comics, I guess. Yeah. Oh!
Wait.
Ta-da! You can get it and support the con. News at 11. Many ways to support the con, including buying this poster. Yay! All right, let's keep with these fabulous...
What? I'm going to say, why is everybody saying I guess now?
Teenagers, am I right?
Don't make me pull you by your pointy ears. Next up, our artist is Tom Zoller. Woo! That was fabulous.
It's my turn now. So now we have the voice of Starlight. Oh my god, I'm so sorry. Starlight Glimmer. Woo! Kelly Freeman.
Hi, every pony, every creature, everyone. Your new headmare will be watching you this Please drink enough water, get enough sleep, and eat enough food, and have so much fun! Woo!
Yo,